Genesis 1:28, quote, "And God blessed them," unquote. The man and the woman he had made, with all the blessing of nature and providence, with all the good things of life, with his presence and with communion with himself in a natural way, through the creatures, and particularly with a power of procreating their species, as follows. Quote, "And God said unto them, Be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth," unquote. If this is not an express command, as the Jews understand it, for marriage and procreation of children, it seems to be more than a bare permission. At least it is a direction and an advice to what was proper and convenient for the increase of mankind and for the filling of the earth with inhabitants, which was the end of its being made, Isaiah 45:18. This shows that marriage is an ordinance of God, instituted in paradise, and is honorable, and that procreation is a natural action, and might have been and may be performed without sin. Quote, "And subdue it," unquote. The earth, not that it was in the hands of others, who had no right to it, and to be conquered and taken out of their hands, but is to be understood of their taking possession, making use of it, of their tilling the land, and making it subservient to their use. Quote, "And have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the face of the earth," unquote, which was giving them an universe and unlimited dominion over all the creatures, of which we see an illumination in Psalms 8:6.